In this video, we're going to discuss transition state theory and activation energy. Transition state theory focuses on a hypothesized intermediate species called an activated complex, which forms during an energetic collision. This exists very briefly and dissociates either back to the reactants or onto products. So we can take a look at a diagram that describes a particular reaction to illustrate this fact. So let's consider hydrogen gas plus iodine gas to give us 2HI gas. If we wanted to describe this particular reaction by a diagram that shows the potential energy on the y-axis and the extent of the reaction on the x-axis, our reactants are going to be H2 plus I2. So here's our reactants at a particular energy. The products are going to be our 2 moles of HI. So we have a particular reaction taking place where our energy diagram looks something like this, and the top point up here is where our intermediate forms. And that intermediate molecule is going to be something that looks like this, where as they collide together, there's kind of a tipping point, okay? And that's that top part right here where right as these guys collide together, they form this intermediate. It exists very, very briefly, and it's either going to dissociate back down to our reactants, which are hydrogen and iodine gas, or it's going to give the products the HI. Okay? This enabled us to look into something called our energy of activation, or our energy of activation barrier, which is given right here. Okay? So by looking at these intermediate states, we can determine a few things about activation energy. So if we think about these particular reactions and we say that if our energy of activation is equal to 171 kilojoules per mole and the delta H is equal to negative 13 kilojoules per mole, what is the energy of activation for the reverse reaction? Okay, so again, we can use the same type of a diagram here where we're going to put energy on our y-axis and our reaction progress on the x-axis, and we can say that here we have our reactants, over here we have the products. Okay, this value right here, this change in energy between A and B, is going to be our delta H. And that's going to be negative 13 kilojoules. Okay, our energy of activation is 171 kilojoules. So remember, the energy of activation goes from a point here all the way up to the intermediate. I'm not going to be able to draw this to scale here because our energy of activation has to be 171 kilojoules. So this right here is going to be 171 kilojoules. So we need to now determine the energy of activation for the reverse reaction. So if we were going from B to A, we need to traverse on this particular path where we're starting with B down here and we're going over to A. And in the process, that means our energy of activation barrier is going to be this arrow that I have right here. So here's our energy of activation for the reverse reaction. And in this case, it's going to be 171 kilojoules plus 13 kilojoules. So that's going to give us a total of 184 kilojoules, and that's going to be the energy of activation for the reverse reaction. Let's do one more problem involving this energy of activation, and what we can say for this one is that if the energy of activation for A going to B is equal to 150 kilojoules per mole, and the energy of activation for B going to A is equal to 100 kilojoules per mole, what is the delta H? All right, so we're going to take this and we're going to plot this particular reaction. We have B to A and A to B. So our A to B, so this is A. Our energy of activation here is 150 kilojoules per mole. So we're going to go up from here to here is going to be 150 kilojoules per mole. And we know going from B back to A is going to be 100 kilojoules per mole. So that means that B has to be right around here because the reverse reaction's energy of activation right here has to be 100 kilojoules per mole. So now we need to figure out what delta H is, and delta H is going to be the difference between A and B, okay? And we know the difference is going to be 50 kilojoules per mole. But the question is this value positive or is it negative? Okay? We are starting at a low energy point with A, and we go up to a higher energy value for B. So that means for this particular delta H, it has to be positive, okay? So if we kind of look back here and look at our first value for delta H, it was a negative value. We started at a higher energy and went down to a lower energy, okay? In this case, when we go from A to B, we start at a low energy and go up to a high energy. So this is a positive and this is a negative delta H. So we can say that this reaction down here is exothermic and this diagram is endothermic. And we're going to use these reaction diagrams throughout the course of the text to help describe reactions. And if you go on to take organic chemistry, you're definitely going to study transition state theory.